first word, big sexy black man. Yes, more than one, sorry. And negative, I would say waka flocka.
Waka flocka flame.
Yeah.
Anything, just first thing. What's the first thing that pops into your mind?
Like, Bob Marley.
Bob Marley? Okay, that's perfect.
It has to be Bob Marley.
It was laid back.
Play like reggae, you know, just play Rastafari.
It automatically is Lil Wayne, first thing that comes to mind. The first negative thing, probably like weed smokers.
Weed smokers, okay.
I mean, possibly, I mean, this could be like Bob Marley's fault, but like, just like, I mean, like weed.
Dirty weed smoker.
Thank
you. Urban or too ghetto, I mean, it's a lot of different stigmas.
I think it's real luck.
Freaky
thugs. Mine is like, kind of like those hippie kids that get the stuff and they don't take care of it. It just looks really funky and stupid.
Hello, everybody. Well, my name is Ryan Roberts, and I'm the director, the producer, the editor, you know, the swag master of this documentary that I decided to call a Locumentary. Now, I named it a Locumentary for a few reasons. The whole purpose of this project was to figure out some of the negative stigmas and perceptions our society, specifically in the business world, has towards dreadlocks. And then, in conclusion, find a remedy and a solution to solve these perceptions and switch it to a positive perception of the
project. Came up with primary and secondary research. Secondary research included information about the origins of dreadlocks and some of the meanings that they had at one time, which they don't have anymore today. Basically, some of the main meanings of dreadlocks when they first, you know, became popular were wisdom, knowledge, basically a lot of good positive terms. But today is a lot of negative terms, as like you see at the beginning of my project.
Now I got inspiration from myself. Basically, I started growing locks 2 years ago, and being a college student at the University of Illinois, I've been through a lot of skin getting looks when I came in, and they were surprised by how articulate I was. So, you know, I'm pretty sure other people who had the same hairstyles and had the same issues. So, I've done research and figured out basically the origin of dreadlocks and figured out some of the original meanings, such as knowledge, wisdom, strength, radicalness. All those were the original meanings of people who grew dreadlocks. You can go to someone with dreadlocks and know that they had divine wisdom that someone else that wouldn't have. And that's something that's difficult, but today the perceptions are completely different. So I did a couple of interviews. I got some different reactions from students and staff and faculty around campus, and also came up with some suggestions for people like myself with dreadlocks who are trying to make it with that hairstyle in the business world. So I hope you all enjoy, and here we go.
That, like as an African-American male, that you need to be aware of. I think, you know, obviously some companies are going to be a lot more conservative than others. So I think, you know, you just need to be aware of it. In my own personal opinion, you know, I got friends with dreads. Like, you know, I don't really think positive or negative. Yeah. It's not like I...
Some of the negative perceptions I think that people have when people with dreadlocks are, you know, that they might be, you know, too urban or too ghetto. I mean, it's a lot of different stigmas and stereotypes that people get with dreadlocks nowadays. I mean, a lot of the stuff you just, you know, what you see on TV, you know, you see a lot of different crimes and acts of violence, you know, that, you know, something just so happens that the person doesn't, you know, a lot of times they have dreadlocks, so how the media portrays dreads and, you know, what they see in celebrities and how the celebrities act, you know, on the camera and how they just carry themselves, you know, it carries over a lot with dreadlocks.
Black hair has been a problem in the business world. Even the afro was not really readily accepted. When African-American women started wearing braids, that became a problem, and there were lawsuits over them being able to wear braids in the workforce. Now, with the evolution of dreadlocks, because of its connection to Rastafarianism and more negative perceptions as being outsider status or conveying an outsider status by the wearer, then there has been problem in accepting dreadlocks in the mainstream. I think that it depends on where you're trying to work, whether or not dreadlocks are accepted. In a position such as working with the university, it may not be as bad as if you're in some of the service sector work. Just like there was recently a black woman who worked for like Worlds of Fun or Great America who was fired because she wore dreadlocks and refused to cut.
Where's your standard of dreads? And so it depends on what you're doing and where you're going. There are a significant number of companies who look negatively on not only, you know, dreads, but, you know, different things like earrings in the ear and such, and so that's the culture. But if you work at more creative companies, you know, that really do not look at dress, they don't look at suit and tie, they don't care, they just want you to produce. And those are usually those companies in creative marketing and such, then it might be acceptable. So it really depends on where you're working.
Okay. I don't know. They don't want to stand close to you thinking that it's going to stink and all. And, you know, I mean, I'm constantly, like, scratching my hair, so they thinking, oh, this guy must have lice or something. So, I don't know, but that's one downside. And people tend to think you're not, you know, you're not serious. You're just out there having fun, and that's all you are. You know, all you are, so.
Catches with dreadlocks, when I first was growing my dreadlocks out, and I don't know, I think it was because they were just short. But then as my dreadlocks started to get longer and lift, and I guess, you know, people categorize longer dreadlocks as looking more professional, you know, then a lot of people just, you know, oh, your dreads look nice, oh, they really do look nice. But before, when they were short, it was just like, you know, oh, man, that looks ghetto.
There's perceptions that I've got that my hair is dirty. People assume that people with locks don't wash their hair when, you know, it's hair. So, you know, you have to wash it as much as you've always washed it before, especially since, you know, I used to have a perm and, you know, I was rocking the pro. So, you know, nothing has changed as far as my routine. A lot of people have, like, I feel like I get like this, people assume I'm like, or something, because I have hair a lot. I don't know, but I noticed that, like, I just don't get any attention from guys anymore. I mean, it's okay, but, you know, I definitely...
No, I'm pretty sure you get your fair share of attention.
No.
The locks completely deaded the attention from the guy?
I think so, and I don't know because they're short, you know, I
think women with locks are beautiful.
But you have locks, so yeah. You can buy it.
There are what they call the roots dreads. They're the dreads that may have one big dreadlock. And they definitely have an outsider relationship to American society. I don't know that they're necessarily the ones trying to go in and get you know, mainstream jobs. But I think that it's all in how you wear your hair. And there is a conservative way to wear dreads. There are more outlandish ways that people are coloring their dreads green or brightly coloring their dreads or making other outrageous statements with their hair that they shouldn't be surprised if they are excluded from the workforce because of that. But I think that, you know, black hair style should be accepted the way that whites, and I don't think that employers are anxious to hire whites who have maybe multiple piercings or have dyed their hair purple or green and things like that. So I think that there's a mode of acceptability with dreadlocks. To be paid and rewarded for your rebelliousness by being able to work in mainstream jobs. So I think that the best thing and the best way to approach that is, you know, just in your personal character. And how you carry yourself, and also how you groom your dress, and make it presentable. You don't want to, again, you know, have that matted, dirty locks.
I don't, in the business world, I mean, I think as long as you have them and are, like, still, like, dressed nice, like, business professional, and, like, do your work and are good at what you do, I don't think there should be a problem with it.
So until you have people that have locks that are making the decisions, which in some areas you do, like you go to an advertising firm, you might see someone with locks.
Mm-hmm.
And which basically makes it easier for an entry-level person to come in with locks. When I got my first job, I remember it was a no-no to have a beard or facial hair. So, yeah. You know, some people would basically, like, if you're interviewing, cut your facial hair off.
Yeah.
When you get in a position where you're comfortable enough or big enough to wear it, then you let your facial hair grow back.
Exactly.
So, I mean, I think locks will probably be the same thing. I think, I think ultimately people want to project a certain image. They want their company to project a certain image. Historically, that image has been white male, clean cut white male family guy.
Yeah.
You know, so now that I think the world has become a lot more diverse, well, it's always been diverse, but in terms of having access to decision making, you know, I think it's up to really the decision makers.
We like to educate people on natural hair and healthy hair, more importantly. But we actually have a blog up, and we're going to be putting some posts up about having locks. Anyone who asks anything about locks, I'm trying to give them the rundown of exactly what it's about. You know, your hair is not nasty, there's not buzz calling my hair, you know, you can comb locks out, they're not permanent. And it doesn't mean that I'm a rockstar. It doesn't mean that I smoke weed. It doesn't mean any of those things. So, you know, it's just a hairstyle. And it doesn't mean I'm trying to be like Lil Wayne or Walker Bucket. It's just a hairstyle.
Start early and grow them longer. I guess the longer they are, I feel like a lot of people, I think it just gives off a look of, like a mature look. I'm not too sure. But I think a lot of it has to do with just how the media portrays, you know, just people with dreadlocks and, you know, just from what people see in the environment from off that portrayal.
If you continue to sport your dreads and you decide that you would rather go into the interview with the look that you have now, of course, in a suit and tie, depending on the corporation, and if you're able to have that interviewer walk away and saying, wow, this is a solid guy, he's going to offer some good insight for my company, he's going to add value, I'm going to hire him with the dreads, then you're beginning to change. So you really are the change. I actually, in this day and time, when students come and ask me should they cut their dreads, I do not say yes anymore. I say, you know, it depends on who you are and what you're going to represent in that interview. If you walk into the door with those dreads and then the interviewer is looking at what you're saying and totally forget about your dreads, that's changing the overall look.